Hey guys, welcome to this SQL tutorial course. In this session, we'll start off by understanding what is a database and then look at the types of database architecture. And finally, we'll understand what is SQL. So what exactly is a database? Well, simply put, it's just an organized collection of data that is stored in an electronic format. More specifically, a database is an electronic system that allows us to easily access, manipulate, and update the data. Now, the modern databases are managed using something known as a database management system. So, a database management system, or DBMS, is basically a system software for creating and managing databases. So, the DBMS provides users and programmers with a systematic way to create, retrieve, update, and manage data. So now that we've understood what exactly is a database and database management system, let's have a look at the types of database architecture. So the database architecture could either be file server or client server. So let's start with the file server architecture. So in the file server architecture, the files are located on your local system. That is, they are local to you. Now, suppose you have an Excel file with you and you send a copy to your friend. Now, if you make any changes in your original Excel file, those changes would not be reflected in the file with your friend. So, in the file server architecture, the server or the local system acts only as a storage device and only one person at a time can access it. So, this is the basic premise behind file server architecture. Now, let's look at client server architecture. So we can see that there are three OLEDB components, or in other words, they are just client systems or the user systems. So we have just shown three over here, but there can actually be n number of systems accessing the database at the same time. So let's say you are logged into the IRCTC website and want to know the number of trains running from one place to another place. So you'll send a request from this system to the network server. Now this network server sends the same request to the database server, and this is finally forwarded to the database. And then the final result is sent back to the user system. So similarly, if there are three users sending the same request, the database server will process all the three requests simultaneously and send back the result to all the three systems. So that was about the types of database architecture. Now let's finally understand what exactly is SQL. So SQL basically stands for Structured Query Language, and it is the standard language for accessing and manipulating databases. Or in simple terms, SQL helps you to communicate with a database. Now the SQL commands can be divided into four categories: Data Query Language, Data Definition Language, Data Manipulation Language, and Data Control Language. So the Data Query Language comprise of just one command, select, though it can be accompanied with many clauses to compose queries against a database. And DDL is that part of SQL that allows a user to create and restructure database objects. So you can see commands like create table, alt table, and drop table in DDL. After that, we have data manipulation language, which is used to manipulate the data within tables. So the three basic DML commands are insert, update, and delete. And finally, we have data control commands, which allow us to control access to data within the database. So these DCL commands are normally used to create objects related to user access and also control the distribution of privileges among users. And you can see commands like grant and revoke in DCL. So this brings us to the end of the session. Thank you very much for attending.